Welcome back to another episode of Wiccans Wicked Reptiles. On this Monday's episode, we're going to talk all about American green tree frog care. Stick around. The American green tree frog is a species of, well, tree frog. And you can find tree frogs all over the world. You can find them in South America, you can find them in Australia, parts of Asia, Europe, and of course North America. And these being American green tree frogs, they live in America. They live in the United States. The southern portion of the eastern seaboard is where you're going to find these guys. They are a crepuscular or nocturnal species, depending on which care sheet you learn from. And these guys are going to be out at night, and they're going to be foraging for their diet, which consists of different types of insects. We'll go into depth with that in a moment. And they're kind of small. They're a smaller frog. These guys in the wild might get up to 2.5 inches, but in captivity, they can go between 2 and 3 inches, depending on what you're feeding them and when you got them and how well they're feeding when they're babies. That's about average 2 to 3 inches in terms of their size. And because they are a small frog, that means they need a smaller size enclosure, or they can use a smaller size enclosure. They can use a huge enclosure if you want as well, but bare minimum I would say is the equivalent of a 10 gallon standing up hive. Which means that the enclosure that I have, which is an Exoterra, kind of a smaller type enclosure with a little bit of height, is perfect. Their measurements on mine are 12 by 12 by 18, which is the equivalent of, well, it's just over 11 gallons, but basically a 10 gallon is what it is. It's a front opening, which is fantastic. Going into the side to get your reptile, or in this case amphibian, is always great. I'm not sure exactly what the natural predators are in the wild, but most amphibians and reptiles, they are looking for things over their heads like birds and things like that. So going on the side is fantastic, and if you have a 10 gallon on its side, you're going to go on the side anyway, so you are a-okay. And in this enclosure, there's a few things you want to consider. First of all, your substrate. So a substrate for these guys, you can use basically anything that holds humidity. An EcoWorth type thing, coconut core. I use something that's completely different than what most people use. You're gonna see it right up here. Beyond Peat is just what I prefer. You can buy it at a hardware store. You get it's basically the same thing as EcoWorth. You just get a ton of it for way less money. And of course you want some furnishings too. You wanna make sure that your amphibian, your green tree frog in this case, can hide. That's what they're gonna wanna do during the day because they are out at night. And what I use for this is just fake plants. Fake plants are perfect for this type of species. You can of course use regular hides like overturned flower pots. Just put them in the top portion of your enclosure. They are an arboreal species. They spend their time in the trees, not on the ground. You'll of course need as well some way to replenish the water. So I've got a really cool system. I've got a waterfall. The entire enclosure that I have here was purchased just like this from someone who had an amazing reptile room. She ran a rescue and she was selling them. She wanted just a good home for them, and well, that's why I have them. I just always wanted an amphibian species that wasn't totally aquatic like the axolotls that I have. So I've got two different types of amphibians now, and I think these guys are really interesting to watch. They hop around a lot. We'll get more into the behavior in a moment. But over top of your enclosure, most reptiles or amphibians need some sort of light source. Now, these guys are okay with just regular light from your room, or in my case, from all the other enclosures from my reptile room here. You don't need a hot spot on these guys as long as the temperature is right. In that case, it's going to be between 70 and 80% degrees, rather, not percent. The humidity will be between 50 and 60%. And you don't need UVB on these guys as well, which is fantastic. Not having UVB, that's an extra expense that you don't need. And I think that is because they are more active during the nighttime and, of course, early morning. So they don't see the sun in the wild anyway. You don't need a UVB bulb for this species of frog. And to circle back around to the heat and humidity, like I said before, 70 and 80% is perfect, which makes it perfect for if you have, say, I don't know, a crested gecko. If you have a crested gecko here and you want to put another tank here, green tree frogs, American green tree frogs, are a perfect species, very similar type of conditions. And then humidity, because they are from not rainforest, but forest, places where it's going to be humid, humidity needs to be a little bit higher than what your house would be. 50 to 60% is considered ideal on most of the care sheets and all the research that I've done. You could even go higher than that. I wouldn't get too crazy. Don't get it 100%, but definitely not below 50%. These are amphibians. They need to be kept at a little bit higher of a humidity than your house would be. And we touched on water. The water, of course, every animal needs water. So a large water dish is probably the best for these guys. Shallow, It's just a good practice, in my opinion, if you have a water dish or a water receptacle that's big enough for your animal to actually get inside of, make it shallow enough that they're not going to drown. I don't know if these guys can swim very well. They're tree frogs. Just because they're frogs doesn't mean that they can swim. I'm sure I could do the research and find out, but it's always just best to make sure that it's shallow enough that if they're inside of it, they can have their head poking out of the water. They're going to use that water, too, to wash down their meals. And what's that? Well, insects. And in the wild, these guys are going to eat things like moths and small crickets and things like that. In captivity, it's going to be hard to find a source of moths. So things like crickets, dubia roaches, if they're small enough, things like mealworms, silkworms, things like that. That's perfect. But also what they can eat is earthworms. I don't suggest catching any bugs, or even if it's earthworms, outside, because there's fertilizers and all sorts of different stuff out there. You don't know what you're bringing into your reptile collection. So I'd suggest don't do that. Go to a reptile store. And if your reptile store doesn't sell night crawlers for whatever reason, you can always go to just a bait and tackle shop, or the corner store by my house sells them as well. This is a great source of food for your reptiles. And if you have an axolotl, like you'll see in this video right here, that's great because those guys eat the same sort of foods that these frogs eat as well. Amphibians are awesome. And if you've been keeping track, it's really easy to keep these guys if you've noticed that trend. Heat and humidity is pretty easy to care for. The heat in my enclosure right now is right around 77%, which is great. Don't let it get above 82, similar to a crested gecko. They'll get heat stroke, and you don't want to get too low unless you're going to brumate them, which is the same thing as hibernation if you're unaware. So everything's been pretty easy up to this point. So is it easy to find them as well? Yes, it is. These guys are not only easy to find, but they're super cheap. And by super cheap, I mean you can buy these guys from between $5 and $20. I think $12 is pretty much average around my area. But of course, south of the border, everything seems to be a lot cheaper, and these guys are no different. I see them on pet sites all the time, different websites that sell reptiles and amphibians, or even like Petco's, which I don't suggest you go to, for about $8. So they're pretty cheap. And that way, if you want to keep a colony of them or several of them together, I've got two in my enclosure here, you can do that pretty affordably. All in all, if you want to get these guys, I didn't really think to do this before my mouth started moving here, but you can get an enclosure, you can get everything you need for the inside of it, and your frogs for probably under $100. This is really great for someone who doesn't want to spend a lot of money to find out that I don't actually want to keep this animal. Just make sure that you have a backup plan. Anytime you go and get an animal, make sure that you do your research first. You have everything set up before you bring it home. And then once you get it brought home, then you observe and you kind of take care of them in the way that you're supposed to. Read care sheets, watch videos like this. Just make sure you know what you're getting yourself into. And if you do not appreciate the animal, if you don't like the animal, like the person who I got this from, they were a rescue and someone surrendered these guys to her, make sure that you have a backup plan. Make sure you know someone who's able to take an amphibian or whatever it is. These guys are pretty simple. Most people who deal with reptiles and amphibians can care for a tree frog pretty easily. Yeah, this is different. If you get yourself a tagu, make sure you have a backup plan. Most places aren't going to take your tagu if you want to surrender it. But these green tree frogs, all in all, are pretty darn simple to keep. They're really interesting to watch. And that brings us to our last portion I want to talk about, behavior. When you bring these guys home, you'll notice that they hide a lot during the day. I've got one guy, like you'll see here, who just kind of hides right in plain sight in the corner, the front of the enclosure where the door is, just leaving enough room for the door to open. I don't know why, it's hilarious, but they will jump around and they've got a pretty good leap. Mine can easily jump from one side of the enclosure to the other side with nothing in the middle, for literally from one end to the other end on the glass. I've got sticky toes, little web toes that they can use to climb walls and things like that, which makes them really interesting to watch, but they're not super flighty. I found out. I thought they were gonna be really flighty. They're not. I can actually poke mine and it doesn't even move. I try to get it in my hand. He wanted nothing to do with it. I don't suggest holding frogs or anything that has a skin that can absorb stuff that would be in your skin. I just wanted to move it and put it in my hand so I could take a little bit of footage of it. I'm kind of glad that it ran away from me. It literally jumped just across. Very interesting. These guys move pretty quick, but they're not super flighty like other species might be. As soon as you walk in a room and just slither away from you, they'll just watch you. And there you have it. That is American green tree frog care in a nutshell. Pretty short video because they don't really need a ton of stuff to keep them happy and healthy. I would rank these guys amongst a beginner. I would think this is a beginner species of amphibian to keep. where we've talked about another type of amphibian before, the axolotl, which is definitely not, in my opinion, a beginner species. If you want an amphibian, you're not really experienced and you're not sure what to get. I think that an American green tree frog is a fantastic beginner species of amphibian. Go and get yourself some green tree frogs if you're trying to get into amphibians. And that's the video for this week. Thank you very much for coming along and watching this care guide for green tree frogs. This has been Monday's episode of Wiccan's Wicked Reptiles, and that means that I'll see you guys again on Thursday. Don't wanna complicate you, complicate you, complicate you.